Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel of the subject Basic Electrical Engineering. And in this chapter of DC circuit, today's topic is time domain analysis of first order RC circuit. Otherwise, you can also say that charging and discharging of capacitor. If capacitor is connected to the DC voltage, then how it gets charged and how it gets discharged? What are the equation? What is the function of charging voltage and charging current? So let's see the theory of charging of a capacitor. So to understand the charging of capacitor, we have to consider one diagram here. In this diagram, you can see that there is one capacitor C, which is having capacitance. It is connected in series with one resistance R. These two are connected in series. And the combination of this resistance and capacitor is connected, or it is supplied by a battery or a DC voltage source V. And there is one switch. So this switch plays the most important role. So at the instant of charging, when the switch is not connected to this either of terminal, the capacitor initially is discharged. There is no charge or no voltage across this capacitor is available. And this is a bidirectional switch, so it can be either connected to 1 and it can be either connected to 2. So basically, we can say that initially capacitor is uncharged. So after the closing the switch, the capacitor is now, if we close the switch at terminal 1, then capacitor will directly get the DC voltage V. So charge will start flowing from battery to capacitor. So capacitor voltage rises gradually, and we need to find the equation of the charging of capacitor voltage. Similarly, the equation of the charging current. So first of all, we have to consider this diagram. In this diagram, there is one capacitor, there is one resistor, they are connected in series, and if we have connected switch at terminal 1, then this voltage source is also connected to this combination. So there are three elements: voltage source, resistance and capacitor. So this is a particularly closed loop or a closed path. At instant, when we have just started this practical, then at this instant, Vc is nothing but the capacitor voltage. I is nothing but the charging current flowing through this closed path. And Q is nothing but the charge on this capacitor plate. So if we apply KVL to this closed path, then the equation will be the applied voltage V is equals to voltage across this resistance, and it is nothing but IR, and plus the voltage across this capacitor, or you can say potential difference or potential drop or potential rise of this capacitor. So it will be V is equals to IR plus VC. But we know that I is nothing but the current flowing through this path. And we have the equation of I as dq by dt, because current is nothing but the charge per time. So q is nothing but cv. We have this equation, q is equals to cv. So let's put the value of q is equals to cv in this equation. So it will be dc dv by dt. So basically, we have to take this C outside because it is a capacitance constant. So we have the equation of current as I is equals to c dv by dt. Let's put this equation of current in this equation of KVL, then it will be capital V, that is the total supplied voltage, is equals to C dV by dt into R plus. So now let's just adjust this equation all terms, then it will be V is equals to VC plus RC dVC by. Our aim is to find the charging voltage. So this first order equation is treated as first order differential equation, and we have to take the Vc on LHS. So it will be V minus Vc is equals to RC dVc by dt. And if this is a first order differential equation, then it can be easily solved by the variable separable method. In variable separable method, dVc and dt should be numerical. So let's take dVc on RHS only, and let's take this dt on LHS. So now dVc and dt is separate. Now all the terms related to the differential term should be bring through that term only. So With this DVC, we take this V minus VC downside. So it will be 1 upon V minus VC into DVC, and this RC is gone with DT. So it will be 1 upon RC into DT. So now we have separated all the variables as DVC upon V minus VC is equals to 1 upon RC into DT. Now multiplying both sides with negative sign. So it will be minus DVC upon V minus VC is equals to 1 upon minus 1 upon RC into DT. We have multiplied both sides by negative sign. Now let's integrate this equation. So in integration, it will be minus DVC upon DT is equals to, in integration, it will be minus 1 upon RC into DT. Now we know that integration of 1 upon V minus VC with respect to DVC, it will be log V minus VC upon minus 1. But we have already multiplied it with minus 1, so it will be minus minus will be cancelled. So it will be log with exponential base, in bracket it will be V minus VC. And on RHS, integration of 1 with respect to DT, it will be T. So it will be minus T upon RC plus some constant, where k is nothing but the constant of this integration. So we obtain equation as log V minus VC is equals to minus T upon RC plus k. Now our aim is to find the value of k. So to find the value of k, we must have to use the initial condition concept. I have told you very earlier before starting derivation that at time t is equals to 0, capacitor was not charged by any value. So we can say that at t is equals to 0, VC was, capacitor was initially discharged, no voltage was available. So let's put this t and VC in this equation, then it will be log V minus 0 is equals to 0 plus k. So we got the value of k as log V. Now let's put the value of k in the equation number 1. So it will be log V minus VC is equals to minus T upon RC plus, instead of k, we will put log V. So this is the equation. We have removed the constant k. Now we can take this both log on LHS, then it will be log V minus VC minus log V is equals to minus T upon RC. And we know that if both log are in subtraction manner, then it can be in denominator manner, that means in division manner. So that means log V minus VC upon VC is equals to minus T upon RC. Here it will be log V minus VC upon V, not VC. Here it will be V is equals to minus T upon RC. Now if you want to find VC, then you have to remove this log. If you want to remove log from LHS, then this RHS term will be in raised to E. So it will be V minus VC upon V is equals to E raised to minus T upon RC. So V minus VC is equals to, if V is taken on RHS, then it will be V minus VC is equals to V into E raised to minus T by RC. And if you make VC subject and this RHS term on LHS, then VC is equals to, if V is taken out from both the term, then it will be VC is equals to V in bracket 1 minus E raised to minus T by RC. When RC is known as the time constant of this circuit, and it is sometimes treated as a lambda. So we got the equation as VC is equals to V in bracket 1 minus E raised to minus T by RC. If we put time is equals to time constant, means if we put T is equals to lambda, then we get the capacitor voltage, charging voltage as 0.632 into V. So that means capacitor is charged at 63% of the total. So this was the equation of charging. Now if you want to draw the characteristics of that charging voltage, then you have to draw the time and VC line. We are finding the characteristics of charging voltage with respect to time. At time t is equals to 0, the voltage of capacitor was 0. And as time was increased, time has elapsed, then capacitor voltage was increasing. It is not increased suddenly, it is increased gradually, and it is function of exponential, so path will be exponential. At some time, after some time t, capacitor will achieve its maximum value as the source value as a V. And if we define t is equals to lambda time, in between this zero and maximum time, then at this time capacitor is achieving 63% of the total. So we can define the time constant as the time taken by the capacitor to charge or to reach its value about 63% of the total applied voltage is known as the time constant of this resistor. So this was all about the charging voltage. Now let's discuss the equation of charging current. So if you want to find the equation of charging current, then we have already obtained the equation of current as I is equals to C dV by dt. In V, you have to put the equation that you have obtained, charging voltage equation. It is V in bracket 1 minus e raised to minus t upon r. And we have to differentiate this term with respect to time t. So this V will be constant. So V can be taken outside. So CV in bracket, you have to differentiate this term only. So the differentiation of 1 will be 0, minus will be as it is. Differentiation of E with respect to T will be E. So it will be e raised to minus t upon RC. But here minus t upon RC can be differentiated again by the chain rule. So it will be minus 1 upon RC. So this minus minus can be cancelled out, and this CV upon RC can be there. And if this CC can be cancelled out, then it will be V upon R on. So we got the equation of charging current as I is equals to V upon R into e raised to minus t upon RC. But we know that V upon R is nothing but the maximum value of the current in that circuit. So basically we got equation as I is equals to Im e raised to minus t upon RC, where RC is the again the time constant, and it can be put as the lambda. So it will be minus t upon lambda. And if we put t is equals to lambda in this equation, then it will give you the answer of charging current I is equals to 0.368 into I. Initially, potential difference was maximum, means battery was having the maximum voltage and capacitor was having the zero voltage. So if potential difference is maximum, then we can say that current flowing through this path will be maximum. But as capacitor gets charged, so that means potential difference decreases. And if potential difference decreases, that means charging current will be decreased. So let's see the characteristics of charging current. So again, we are drawing the time, and again we are drawing IC, that is the charging current on the y-axis. And at zero time, when this practical was started, current was its maximum value at I. And as time has gone, the current has been decreased in gradually exponential manner, and at some time, current is now zero because capacitor is fully charged. So in case of charging current, the characteristics will be like. And at some time t is equals to lambda, capacitor current, charging current has been decreased by its value about 36% of the maximum value. So we can define the time constant of capacitor in terms of charging current as it is the time taken by the capacitor charging current to decrease its value from the maximum about to 36% of its maximum value, and that time is known as the time constant. So this was all about the charging of capacitor. Now let's see the discharging of capacitor. Once capacitor gets charged, now no current can flow from battery to capacitor or capacitor to battery. So we have to change the position of switch. And if we change the position of switch and some element is connected in that path with capacitor, then capacitor discharge itself through that element. So here we are replacing the position of switch as 2, and now the path will be this, and in this path capacitor will be discharged through this resistor. So here Vc is nothing but the potential drop across the capacitor, I is the discharging current, and Q is the charge available on capacitor. And initially we can say that when we are just replacing this switch from one terminal to two terminal, so at this time t is equals to zero, capacitor is having the maximum voltage as the battery, that is V. So here initial condition is t is equals to zero and Vc is equals to. Now let's apply KVL to this circuit, this small closed path. So if we are applying KVL to this path, then there is no source. So zero is equals to capacitor voltage plus resistor voltage. And resistor voltage Vr is nothing but I cap. So we will put 0 is equals to Vc plus I. We know that I is equals to C dV by dt. So if we put this C dV by dt in this equation, then it will be 0 is equals to Vc plus Rc dV by dt. Now we have two terms, so we can put either one term on LHS and one term on RHS. So it will be Vc is equals to minus Rc dVc by dt. Again, we have to separate this equation because this is a first order equation. So we can separate dVc on one side and we can separate dt on another side. So it will be dVc upon Vc is equals to minus dt upon Rc. Now if we integrate this equation, then it will give us log Vc, because 1 upon Vc with respect to Vc is log Vc, is equals to integration of 1 with respect to t will t. So it will be minus t upon Rc plus constant k1. Here k1 is the constant of integration. And we need to find the value of this k1. So to find this value of k1, we must need to use the initial condition. So in this case, initial condition is at time t is equals to 0, capacitor voltage was maximum, because at starting of this practical voltage was maximum. So if we put this value in equation number 1, so we get log V is equals to 0 plus k1, because it was log Vc. So instead of Vc, we have put V. So log V is equals to k1. So k1 is equals to log V. Let's put the value of k1 in the equation that we obtained. So it will be log Vc is equals to minus t upon Rc plus log V. Let's combine two log on LHS. So it will be log Vc minus log V is equals to minus t upon Rc. If two log are in subtraction manner, then it can be in division manner. So it will be log Vc upon V is equals to minus t upon Rc. If you want to find the discharging voltage equation Vc, then you have to remove this log. So Vc upon V is equals to e raised to minus t upon Rc. And we know that Rc is nothing but the time constant of this circuit. So we can put lambda also. So we got this equation of discharging voltage as Vc is equals to V in bracket e raised to minus t upon. So this is nothing but the discharging voltage. If you want to draw the characteristics of discharging voltage, then you have to draw time versus discharging voltage Vc. And here at zero time, discharging voltage was maximum, and as time gone, discharging voltage is decreased gradually in exponential manner. It was maximum earlier, and at some time t is equals to lambda, discharging voltage is 0.368 times V. So you can define time constant as the discharging voltage taken time required to decrease its value from the maximum to 36% of its total value. Now let's find the discharging current. So if you want to find the discharging current, then again take the same equation of KVL, that is 0 is equals to Vc plus IR. So you need to find the discharging current IR. So we can take IR is equals to minus Vc. So let's put the value of Vc in this equation. So it is V into e raised to minus t by Rc. If we are putting this R on the RHS side, then it will be I is equals to minus V upon R into e raised to minus t upon Rc. But we know that V upon R is the maximum current. So I is equals to minus Im into e raised to minus t upon Rc. So we got the equation of discharging current similar to the charging current also. But the change is that there is a negative sign, which denotes that the discharging current direction will be in opposite to the charging. So in this video, you have seen the charging and discharging of capacitor. Thanks for watching this video. Stay tuned.